Welcome to the energy vibration reading for the last week of June for you Sagittarians. I want to say thank you for being here. Thank you for being back. This week begins from the 25th until the 1st of July. And I want to say to each and every person, thank you for your supports, likes, and shares. Please thumbs up and like these videos. But also, it's a wonderful week for you, Sagis, because the energy of the Wheel of Fortune is here. The Zodiac energy is going to be water and emotional, but not to worry about that. Now, I'm doing this reading from out my room. So let's see. So welcome to my little room. And let's see what is happening for you, Sagittarians. Okay. So we have the energy of the Knight of Cups. Whoever this Knight of Cups is, they're coming in. And we are going to be seeing what exactly is transpiring with the energy of this Knight of Cups for you, Sagittarius. Oh. Ace of Pentacles. The Lovers. Wonderful. Oh my gosh. Fabulous. Fabulous. Okay. So, Two of Pentacles. So you have to make a decision. You have to make a decision, you Saggy. Okay. So it's as if some of you ladies, and yeah, this could be a wonderful relationship you're about to start. Some of you could be in another relationship and you have met someone who has turned the wheels of your heart chakra. And you have the Eight of Coins, the Eight of Coins. So you're going to be working on this relationship. I'm really loving this because this is a wonderful situation that is coming out. Then you have the energy of the Hangman. So some of you are looking for and trying to understand what basically is happening. Some of you have met someone who is a Pisces, Cancer, or Scorpion. You feel a love connection and you're waiting to see if it's something that you can go forward with, or is it just something that is just coming out of the blues? Okay. What else is here for the weekend? You have the King of Swords. Okay. So some of you could be connecting with someone who is a Aquarius, Gemini, or Libra. Whoever this person is, it could be a love connection that is coming up, but we're going to be looking forward to see what is coming out, and there's going to be a heartbreak. Okay, so what I should also say, you know, your weekend is going to be, some of you are going to be having a loss, whatever the situation is. Some of you are going to be having a loss in the weekend, and we are going to look and see what is basically Three of Pentacles. So a lot of people will be connecting with people. So your outcomes of this week is going to be the energy of the Three of Pentacles. So the Three of Pentacles is basically connecting together, working together with others, and that sort of a situation, which is going to bring a positive energies in, but also it's, you're going to be connecting in a very, very positive way. Okay, so whatever is happening, basically in this week, we are going to be taking a look. Okay, so the weekend is not going to be such a viable weekend for you because of a situation that has to do with the King of Swords. The energy of the King of Swords is always a holder man over the age of 40 that you're going to have to be dealing with. And it was a love relationship for some people. For some people, you connect with him as a lover. But whatever the situation is, it's coming to an end. So let's see the Knight of Cups. I'm loving the energy of the Knight of Cups. This is good. A lot of you are going to be working together with the Knight of Cups. The Knight of Cups is, could be someone who is coming in as a new business relationship or as a lover, because the energy of the Lover is here, and it's as if you're going to go in business with someone who is a Pisces, Cancer, or a Scorpion. Okay, and this is going to be a good business deal, because whatever is happening is that this person is going to be making things happen for you as you connect with them. energy of the Nine of Cups, happiness and joy. So this is going to be really, really positive. Some of you are connecting with a Pisces, Cancer, or a Scorpion, and this connection is going to bring your wishes and dreams coming true, and in a positive way, because you have good positive energies, especially around the lovers, because some of you are going to be connecting with someone from a past life, a soulmate or a twin flame from a past life, in business and in love. This is a wonderful week that this is going to be happening. Some of you are going to be connecting with the Pisces, Cancer or Scorpion, men between the ages of 25 and 45, and some of you are going to be connecting with Aquarian, Gemini and Libran, men over 40. Okay, whatever the situation, whatever the business transaction and situation, it's going to be good. Now if you were about to do a business deal or something with someone, be careful what you do. Be careful what you do. The energy of the Ten of Swords is there. There could be things that are not being told, but we're going to be looking at that to see exactly. Now, some of you, it can be coming out to the end of the week that you're connecting and you have to make a decision about a situation that you have been working very hard, and some of you are going to make a decision about a situation. Now let's see what is first coming up for the Knight of Cups and the Lovers. What is this energy for the Knight of Cups and the Lovers? Oh my God, go girls, ladies and gentlemen. I am loving this for you guys, because what is happening is that whoever you ladies are about to connect with, a Pisces, Cancer, or a Scorpion, this is going to end up in a long relationship. You're going to get married to this person. This is the man of your dreams. Go for it. Kudos to you guys. I'm loving this. This is fabulous. This is love is in the air, and some people out there, if you haven't met this person, you are about to meet this person. There's an offer that is coming in. There's a wonderful, beautiful offer that is about to come in for you. There is an offer, and this offer is going to make your wishes and dreams come true. Okay, let's see what is happening with the Hangman, the ghost hanging in limbo. What is happening? Some of you have a relationship or have met someone that is a Pisces, Cancer or a Scorpion. You're hanging in limbo with the situation, but it's going to get better, because you both are going to be connecting, and you both could end up being married or living together or having a wonderful situation. The Seven of Swords. So you were hanging in limbo because there was a situation that was going on with an Aquarius, Gemini or Libra. Whatever, this person tries to get away with something, and whoever this person is, they're connected to the Pisces, Cancer or Scorpion. For some of you this man is connected to the Pisces, Cancer or Scorpion. For some of you, this man has tried to get away with something, but it's not going to happen. I think he tries to keep you both apart, but it's not going to happen, because it's as if the universe is coming in and saying, hell no, it's not going to happen. Let's see what is coming out in the weekend, because in the weekend there is an energy of an air energy. Now that is the emotional part of your week. It's going to be in the weekend, because let's see, the king is here, and he is a water, is an Aquarius, a Gemini or a Libra. Let's see what is happening. Why is there the Three of Swords? Looking in within yourself. There is a situation that you have to take a good look at. And some of you are going to have this at the end of the week. Thursday going on Friday. From Thursday to Friday, the week energy has changed. From Friday, the week energy has changed. But not to worry. I'm sorry. We're doing this cozy a room thing this week. Not to worry. What is happening is that new love is about to enter your life. And this is going to be a positive love and a positive energy. Whatever has been here and whatever that has transpired in the past, you are going to be receiving wonderful, positive new love coming in. So for the people who have met a Pisces, Cancer, or a Scorpion between the ages of 25 and 40, and you were thinking, you know, is this what? Is it going to work out? Is this, what is he? What does he want? And that sort of a thing. You are going to realize that this man really wants to be with you. I'm seeing children being born in this week, which is wonderful. Some of your wishes and dreams are going to come out. Maybe the dream and a wish that you hope for a child, it's going to be coming out. Some of you might be realizing that you're pregnant in this week and this sort of a thing. Okay, so this is a good outcomes for you guys in this week. The Page of Cups is always the energy of love. My situation and what I'm like a little bit worried over is that this Ten of Swords, who is this and what is really happening? Because some lies, you have to find inner strength, because some lies is here and we need to know what is happening with this Ten of Swords. Who is lying? And Cups, the Five of Cups, regrets. So there was some lies that has been told and there's regrets, because you're trying to find inner strength to deal with a situation, and it has to do with making a decision, money and working hard. Making a decision, money and working hard. Okay, let's see what exactly is transpiring with this King of Swords and this loss, and you looking within. The Eight of Swords, you're seeing now the situation for what it is, because there was some lies. See, we had first the Seven of Swords. You're thinking about what is happening to you. And then you are seeing a situation clearly. And we want to know, because I'm building on this, because what was stolen? What was the lie all about? Why are you trying to find inner wisdom and guidance for this situation? The Moon, listen to your intuition, because you had a feelings about something. You knew something was arrears. You knew something was going on. Listen to your feelings about a situation, because obviously an offer comes in, but be aware of there's no, basically no hidden agendas. It is basically that it's as if someone is trying to do something, and it's from an organization. So here we are. We have the energy of the Moon. Listen to what is happening here. Listen to what is coming out. So what is it from your boss or your supervisor? Because some of you are going to be realizing something. Hold on. Let's see what is going to be the outcomes between listening to your intuition about your ex-boss or an override situation, and it flies out. You're seeing the situation for what it is. You have saw the lies and all that has transpired. You realize that there was a lot of lies and you're now having a regret. So I think I'm kind of understanding this, what is going on, because it's all about working together, people working together. Okay. And what is happening in this week, what is basically happening is that in love, it's going to be perfect. It's going to be wonderful. Is that you guys are meeting a Pisces, Cancer, and a Scorpion. And this is going to be good, because you're going to be working together. This is going to be a relationship. This is going to be a relationship that you have been waiting for. Your wishes and dreams are going to be coming out about this relationship. Someone is going to offer is going to ask you to answer in marriage, and is going to say yes. It is going to be good. And what I'm looking at is that there's an offer, there's a new offer that is coming in. There was a new offer and you decide to go with that, and now you're having some regrets, because you're seeing that the organization that you have been working with or connecting with has been lying and deceiving, and it's as if you are trying to find strength about this organization, because this organization is very, very deceptive. And whatever they have done is as if you find out that they, it's as if it's a third party that you got someone in via, and then you're realizing that they put you up to make, to say something that wasn't right, or to it's as if they wanted you to disqualify someone, or that sort of a thing, or do something to make the another person feel bad. And then you're thinking, oh my God, I wish I had done that, because this person basically is good, and this person could do their work, or that sort of a thing. So it's all about work, and it's all about as if you got someone like a third party, like a bureau, and they put you up to say that the person couldn't do their work, and now you're feeling bad about the situation, and you want to rectify the situation, but you don't know how to. What is going to happen is that in the weekend, you're trying to find inner stability in the weekend, because you have to deal with someone who is an Aquarian, a Gemini, or a Libra. And you're having outbreaks with this person because this person put you up to do this. And now you're seeing that you have done something of injustice against another person. You're not sitting and feeling very well about that, because now you're understanding this person, this organization, that they have lied, and you have placed someone in a bad light, which you know that the person is basically not that type of a person and that sort of a situation. So it's as if, or it could be vice versa, that someone has done this to you, or you have done this to someone. So it's going to be working a vice versa for you guys, okay? But in the weekend, you're going to be realizing that this person, I need to get away from this man over 40 that is an Aquarius, Gemini, or Libra. I really need to get away from this person, because this person is a really dishonest person, okay? The outcomes is that you're finally seeing the truth to a situation, and you're going to end it, okay? Let's see. Luck, you're another sign that is getting a little surprise coming in. You Sagittarius, a little surprise, and this is a surprise, a new birth in the family, or you're going to be finding out that you are, and then you have a surprise. Some of you could be traveling, okay? So this is wonderful. This is good. Good news. It could be surprise from abroad, that maybe someone is coming in to visit you, or a message about money from abroad, and this is going to be good. Okay, so some of you could be receiving also a message from overseas. It could be that you have a business and your business start to take off overseas. This is going to be very positive and very good. Okay, so I want to end this reading, and I'm saying namaste. I am wishing you a lot of success in this week. You have really a bundle reading. So namaste from out my bedroom. Bye.